जब अंतर्यामी ने देखा हर अंतर में वही वास करे, लिए अमर मिलन की अभिलाषा सखियां उनसे ही आस करे। वे निवेदिताएं सदर्पिताएं उन पर ही विश्वास करे, तब निश्चित किया पुरुषोत्तम ने अब सखियों संग वास करे।
बहुत ही सुंदर,
वेरी गुड।
This remembers me Indian song and dance. Especially on Sri Krishna, how he used to dance with Gopi and sing, this is like that. So I appreciate this very, very. Gautama. ज्ञानचमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो. महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिसे नमः. गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदाले कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो नमः. तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नय माम चरणा. First of all, my hearty obeisance in the lotus feet of my spiritual master Nityalila Pravishtam Vishnu Pada Sutta Sishmat Bhakti Pragyan Krishna Goswami and same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Nityalila Pravishtam Vishnu Pada Sishmat Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj. I wanted to speak in Hindi about Sanatana Dharma, but I see very few number of Hindi hearings. So I should anyhow speak in English language. Perhaps you know that my English is very poor. But yet I will try to speak. You know that Krishna, He took birth from the womb of Mother Yashoda in Gokul, and also he took birth in the jail of Kals from Devaki Mother Devaki, and he killed so many demons. And then he did so many sweet pastimes. In the end he did ras with lakhs and lakhs gopis, dancing with gopis, singing with them. And then he did Dwarka Leela. When he was going to, he finished his sweet pastimes of Braja and Dwarka. In Golok Vrindavan he was thinking, I am Vishaya of prey.
object.
Understand?
Object.
Object of prayer.
Object of prayer.
Object of love. And my sakhas, Subal Siddham and others, Mother Yashoda Nanda, all the elderly gopis of Braja, and especially the Braja Gopi, are reservoir of prem. He is thinking that I enjoyed so much Satkharas, Vatsalyaras, Madhuras, everything. But in the end I saw when Radhika see me, then he becomes mad, totally mad. I think that I am ki sundarta ka ant hu,
supreme limit of beauty
and supreme
limit,
beautiful in this whole world, all transcendental world. But I see Radhika is more beautiful than me. She is my guru of my love, affection. She is my sakha. She is my friend. She is all things of me. So, even I am superior in all things, but there is something in me that Srimati Radhika at once becomes mad. What is in me? And what kind of love and affection she feels when she sees me? I want to enjoy like Radhika. But I am not Radhika. Then how can I enjoy all these things? What is in me? Then he thought, if I can take the beauty and mood of, intrinsic mood of Radhika, I may test all these things. And this way, I will give whole world how to enter in this Radhanuga bhakti, that one day they can be perfect and they will come to Golok Vrindavan. That is why, thinking this, he took the beauty, golden beauty, and intrinsic mood. What? Sneha, man, pranay, rag, anurag, bhav, mahabhav, rud, adirud, modan, and in the end, madan bhav also, which is not in anyone of Lalita, Visakha, himself, Krishna. So he took the beauty. And then he came in Kali Yuga. He came as Sachinandan Gaur Hari. His beauty was golden. And he has taken the beauty. But even he did not knew how to enjoy this thing. That is why he took sannyas, left old mother and very beautiful young wife, Vishnu Priya Devi. And then he came to Puri. And from Puri, he went to Godavari River, on the bank of Godavari River, where Raya Ramananda, the Governor General of Maharaj Pratap Rudra, was there as a ruler of that place. When he was there, in the morning Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took bath in Godavari and he was sitting on the bank of Godavari. In the meantime, King representative, that Governor General Raya Ramananda, very learned person, he came on palanquin with hundreds of Brahmins reciting Veda mantra. But when he saw Raya Ramananda, a very young sannyasi, renounced order person, at once, he was attracted. And after taking bath, alone, he came to Mahaprabhu Sachinandan Gauhari, who was in sannyas order. Then Mahaprabhu asked him, he left his royal dresses, only in one dhoti. Then Mahaprabhu at once told him, are you Raya Ramananda? And then he told, yes, I am Das Ramananda. I am servant of Raya Ramananda. Your Das. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that I have come to you to hear some Harikatha. Then Raya Ramananda Prabhu told, then what you will inspire me, I may tell you. Better we should meet in evening, anywhere. Then evening, they met there. And there is a big Raya Ramananda Sambhav in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Mahaprabhu asked him, what is your sadhya? Then he began to tell from beginning, Varnashram Dharma. Understand Varnashram, India's Varnashram Dharma? Varne Ashram Dharma. That Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra, and Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and Sannyasi. What is their sadhan and then sadhan? And he began from being situated in Varna Ashram Dharma. We should serve Vishnu. Mahaprabhu told, it is bahya,
it is external.
External. In this way he rejected Gita sloka also, sarva dharmana parityajya maham ekam saranam vraja, aham tvam sarva papebhyam vakshayishyami maham. He rejected also jnana mishra bhakti, brahma bhutah prasannatmana sochati na kankshati, samastarvesh bhutesu mad bhaktim labate para. What meaning? Bolota. He is.
Can I blow up the slope? I will.
বসে বসে বলো, খালি ব্রহ্মপুত্র শ্লোকেই বলবো, একটু ব্যাখ্যা করতে সময় অর্থ বলিয়ে দাও।
ओम अज्ञावति मिदांधस्य ज्ञानांजन सलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। श्री गुरुदेव फॉरम में डिस्कस अबाउट रायमंगल संवाद श्लोक मेंशन अवर टीचर ब्रह्मभूत प्रसन्नात्मा न शोचति न कांक्षति सम सर्वेषु भूतेषु मद्भक्ति लभते परम। ब्रह्मभूत प्रसन्नात्मा इन दिस श्लोक मेंशन दैट ब्रह्मभूत ब्रह्मभूत मीन्स हु इज ऑलवेज हैप्पी इज विथ हिज ओन आत्मा ओन सोल एंड फॉर दैट He never repent and never thankful for anything. He always happy himself. Like you can see the four Kumaras, Sanat, Sanandan, Sanatan, Sanat Kumar, they're happy always. But at the beginning stage, they are not high class devotee. Srila Sukadeva Goswami, he was in beginning stage, He was Brahmabhuta, always happy with himself, with his own soul. But in this world it is mentioned that no sochati no kamsati, they never lament and not hankering anything. Because if you have, you are hankering for something, you could not get that, then you lament. But Brahmabhuta, they are not lamenting or hankering. Sama sarvesu bhuteshu, they are equal vision to all. They never think some are suffering, some are serving, they think all are equal. But is possible there will be great devotee? Great devotee always happy. They never lament and not hanker. How it is possible for them, Sukadeva Goswami and Paul Kumaras, How they will be great devotee and who like themselves, how they will be devotee. Then, madhbhakti, samasarvesu bhuteshu madhbhakti labhate param. If they got any good association, then possible for them to be a good devotee. As for example, Sukadeva Goswami, when he took bath, he does not like to take bath in this Maya jagat, in this illusion of Maya. He was living in his mother's rooms about 12 years. His father Vyasadeva, who composed Srimad Bhagavatam and all Puranas, he told, which is your mother's home, please come out. He told, I will not come out in this Maya. Vyasadeva replied, I can remove Maya from here. Sukadeva Goswami, being in mother's home, he told, I have no trust on you. If only Sri Krishna will come and tell this, I have faith on him only, no one, nobody else. Then Vyasadeva remembered Krishna and Krishna appeared there and told, I am Sri Krishna, I am moving my Maya for a second, less than a second, you have to come out from his mother's womb. If you drop a mustard seed on the edge of a blade, how long you can stay there for that time I can even Maya? So Krishna did so. Sukadeva Goswami came out from mother's womb and ran away from there into forest. So Maya should not touch him for that. Vyasadeva is thinking, oh, he was qualified to learn Srimad Bhagavatam. In this world, there's no one so qualified like himself. How to get him back? He was thinking. So one day, some hunters who is catching birds and selling in the market, They are going to forest. Then Vyasadeva asks, where you are going? Oh, we are going to catch some birds and to sell to maintain our life. Then Vyasadeva told, I can tell you some mantras. If you recite this mantra, you will get more parrots. Then Vyasadeva told that Putana, Rasthasi told that the beauty of Sri Krishna. Balha Priyam Natavarabhu Karna Yokarni Karam Dipradvasakana Kapati Sambhayantin Chamalam Ramha Nabeja Radha Sudaya Purayana Gopavindari Vrindavan Namsapadaramanam Pradishad Gita Kirti. So the Buddha needs to explain, although in the three places of Srimad Bhagavatam, the beauty of Krishna mentioned by our Purvacharya Purva, first guru, four-headed Brahma, then Brahman Patnis of Mathura, the last one by Braj Gopi, is the best. Krishna's beauty described in Srimad Bhagavatam in all scriptures. So, hearing this, they got more powers. And next day again they came and done that, they recite another sloka. Aho bhakyam stanakala kutam jigam sarap pasaddi lebe gotin dhatu chitam katannam kamra dhyalum saranam rajima. Putana came to Braj to kill Krishna, sent by demon king council. But what happened? Krishna suck his life here with his breast. But in breast there is no milk at all, only strong poison. Unless until mother has no baby, breast milk will not come down. Putana has no baby, only poison. And Krishna, what he did? He gave her motherlyhood position in Golok. So hearing this, Sukadeva Goswami heard this sloka and came out from the palace with them to Vasudev. Then Vasudev taught him Srimad Bhagavatam. By the association of Bhagavatam, association of Srimad Siddhasdev, he became great devotee. Mm-hmm. Even if Brahmahuta Bhakti is there, if he comes in good association, he will be pure bhakta and very good devotee. So Mahaprabhu told it is external. What is after that? And what is the essence of this dialogue between Ramananda Rai and Mahaprabhu? We listen from Gurudev's lotus feet. Hare Krishna. Pancha Kalpataru Bhakta Kipasam Dhyayavaka Satyakanam Sagaradhyo Krishna Jalipo.
Then Mahaprabhu told, it is also external. Then he told, Karma Mishra Bhakti. Jat karosi, jadasnasi, jat dahosi, tat kurusta sarva karpranam. What you are doing, what you are eating, what you are drinking, everything you should
offer to me.
Mahaprabhu is related also. This is not pure bhakti. This is karma mishra bhakti. Then Rajaman told Satang Prasangam Vidya Sambhidav Bhavante Rit Karna Rasayana Katha Tadjo Sanat Asu Apavad Matmani Sadharati Anukrameshyati. Oh, pure bhakti. What? Hearing Satan Prasangam of Vidya Sambhito. When high class of Vaishnavas met together, so much high class of sweet pastimes of Krishna regarding this. Oh, Harikatha, always flowing like a river from their mouth. So he telling Satam Prasangam Vidya Sambhido Bhavanti Rit Karana Rasayana Katha Tadjo Sanat Asu Apavarg Vatmani. By hearing this, first Sadhan Bhakti comes, then Bhavakti comes, and the Prema Bhakti comes. Mahaprabhu, yes, something. Go on more. And then he told, Raramananda, two slokas. One of Vaidhi Bhakti. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasivanam Archanam Bandhanam Darsam Sakhyatmani Vedanam. Hearing about Krishna, sweet pastimes, his qualities and other things. Kirtan. Always like Sukadeva Goswami, Kirtan, not only Kirtan, that Kirtan, Harikatha Kirtan. We are doing Kirtan. Then smaranam, remembering Krishna and his sweet pastimes. Padasevan, archanam, vandanam, like all these things. And then he told about Raganuga Bhakti.
Krishna Bhakti Rasabhavita Moti.
Krishna Bhakti Rasabhavita
Moti.
क्रियतां कुतोपि यदि लभ्यते तत्र लौल्यमपि मूल्यमेकलं जनकोटिषु कृतज्ञं इफ यू हैव एनी एसोसिएशन ऑफ ए रसिक भक्त देन ट्राई टू बाय हिज ऑल हरि कथा. And by that, Krishna Bhakti Rasa Bhavita, nothing kriyatam yadi labhyate, tatra laulyamapi. Then you will have laulya, very thick greed, a strong greed to serve Krishna, like gopis. Then Mahaprabhu, yes, go on, very good. After that, he told of Sakya of Braja, how Subal, Siddham, Madhumangal, Subal and others are serving Krishna, fighting with Krishna, defeating even Krishna, and without a second they cannot live without Krishna. Oh, if they are eating anything, oh, it is very sweet, tasteful, then they take out and give it to Krishna
by force.
In this way, something. Oh, this is Sakharas. Then he told, oh, more, one more, very sweet. Then he told about Vatsalyaras. Maa Yashoda, always giving breast, Krishna drinking. He is not satisfied by Brahma Stav Stuti and by sacrifices, legs and legs. But if Maa Yashoda binds him in God,
grinding mortar,
and Krishna weeps. Sometimes Mother Yashoda takes a stick.
Shall I beat you?
Very naughty boy. To whom?
Supreme Lord
Krishna, Lord of Lords. And then he told Mother, don't beat me. Don't you? And crying, tears coming. You cannot imagine. Yashoda never thought that Krishna is Supreme Lord. Oh, my dear son, Valli, ignorant son.
Naughty.
Oh, this is Vatsalya Rasa. Nand Baba, you to tell? No. Oh, bring my source. And Krishna dancing, taking his
sandal
and doing nitya,
dancing,
he used to come. You know, that for makhan,
butter,
makhan stuff is very, very sweet. Mother Yashoda saw that all are complaining against him that he is
stealing.
He stole makhan from their houses. And then Mother Yashoda thought, in my house, what I make
butter,
makhan, it is not sweet. And that is why Krishna, here my maid servants are doing. Now, today, from today, I will myself milk whelps, Padma Gandha and other cows. Their milk has good smell like
lotus flower.
Lotus flowers. And in this way, he now started to make makhan from
yogurt.
In this way, Krishna was sleeping and came weeping, and by one hand he took the
churning stick
and by other
bell of Mother Yashoda.
And he saw that, oh, this is my son, and he took in his. And after that, you know that even Krishna was not satisfied. Mother Yashoda went, keeping Krishna. Oh, Krishna, sit down. With one hand, without any labor. Putana, having 10,000 elephants power, as strong as 10,000 of them. And he was
trying to give up me.
And both hands, she wanted to
push Krishna back.
Remove Krishna. But could not. And Mother Yashoda given her, sit down.
And at that time Krishna was only 6 days, and now 2.5 years.
And then Krishna and went. And then Krishna was very angry, and he
break the pot.
Matki ko tod diya.
Break the vessel with the
Then Mother Yashoda. Oh, chastised him, caught him, and wanted to bind him. He took all the ropes of his
house
of all the
cows
and two fingers,
two swords,
lace always. He went on continuously, one rope, second, third, fourth, fifth. It became so long, and Krishna rest was only 12 fingers, but could not bind one detail. What were two fingers? One, disciples,
devotees' effort.
And second, mercy of Krishna. Without seeing your
endeavor
to bind Krishna, Krishna mercy will not come. So when we will do bhajan like Raghunath Das Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, like Gaur Kushor Das Babaji Maharaj, without eating, whole day, night, waking, chanting name, Sankhya-purvaka-nāma-gān natibhi-kāla-vasāni-kṛtau nidra-hār-vihār-kādi-vijitau-chātanta-dhīrau. Not even sleeping, always day and night chanting, weeping. So if you will do bhakti like that, then you can take the darshan of Krishna and serve him, otherwise no. So we should try to do like that. Then Krishna mercy will come and we will be perfect. Mahaprabhu told, oh, very sweet, go on board. And then he continued and told Raramananda, the bhakti of gopis is highest. How they serve Krishna. They have left their husband, children, father, mother, wealth, house, everything for Krishna. And they serving Krishna in all respect to please Krishna. Krishna is telling them, "O gopis, I cannot repay you. We have left everything, but I cannot give up anyone, my father, my mother, my friend, my any devotee, even today, those who are worshipping me. How can I give up? So I cannot repay you. But you are really sadhu. So by your own qualities, oh, you can
free from death.
You can repay me. But I will be always
debted to you. Debted to you.
Debted to you. This is gopi. But in these gopis, who is highest, who has highest love and affection for Krishna? That is Srimati Radhika. Anyone cannot be compared. Even Lalita, Visakha, Chandravali or anyone. Mahaprabhu told, "Oh, very good. I want to hear more and more." Oh, then he told, Raramananda, he was Visakha Sakhi in Krishna pastime. Raramananda began to tell, "I never know anyone that who can ask, who wanted to know more than this, the love and affection of Radhika. But one thing is there, and that is Rasaraj Mahabhav." Radhika is telling, Raramananda is telling, "Pahila hi rag nana bhari bhava." There was no duty,
no messenger.
That who can meet me, Radha and Krishna. Only I saw you and you saw to me. And then four eyes met. And that our love and affection went growing, growing and growing. No place even, it is growing. But now you have gone to Mathura Dwarka. Where is that duty? I'm very much feeling separation and want to meet you. Raraman told that this poetry I have done myself. Any awareness. Then Mahaprabhu stopped. Thus, don't tell anything. Otherwise, oh, I'll be turned into Krishna. So he stopped his mouth. Oh, here Srimati Visakha, that is Raramananda, is very near and dear Sakhi of Srimati Radhika. He knows all Radhika's moves because always with her. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sachinandan Gauhari, Krishna in the form of Sachinandan, went to his school, her school, and taking training from her. So Visakha is now Siksha Guru of Krishna. Without her help, he cannot test O Radha move. Only Visakha knows Radha's mood. So he was trained there. And then he requested Raya Ramananda, oh, please come to Jagannath Puri. Give up Governor Generalship and other things. And we will both there. Oh, we will enjoy Krishna Katha with gopis. And then Raya Ramananda also left that job. King told that if you are going to Sachinandan Gaudhari, I will give you same salary as I am still giving. And you can be with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then he went to Jagannath Puri, and in Gambhira now, what he wanted, what was three
desires,
object of Krishna to come like Sachinandan Gaudhari, he fulfilled. Radhaya Pranay Mahima Kitrisho. What is the Pranay Mahima? Pranay means Prem, Sneh, Man, then Pranay. The high class of Prem. How this is in Radhika? And he tests my four Madhuri, Rupa Madhuri,
Guna Madhuri,
Guna Madhuri,
Lila Madhuri,
Venu Madhuri, Lila Madhuri. How sweet she tests only, Radhika only. And what happiness comes in her heart by hearing all these things. Now Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was fulfilling here his desire in Gambhira. Sometimes he used to go out of seven doors closed with iron gates. How he used to go
out?
And he jumped in ocean. And for one day and night he was drowning and coming up and down in ocean in Jagannathpur, very high class of vats there.
Very dangerous.
Dangerous. When he came out, then he told, why you brought me here? I heard the
flute
voice. And at once I went in Jamuna. I was playing with Krishna and gopis in Jamuna. How you brought it? In this way he was testing all these things. After that, what became? Any song?
Kirtan.
Any song? Can be. Hindi song. Jaja Radha Ramana Hari Bol. Jaja Radha Ramana Hari. जय श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु।
मुझे तो हिंदी बोले दिन वाले, मुझे तो हिंदी बोले दिन, पांच मिनट
हिंदी में बोल दें। इसके बाद में श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु जी वृंदावन जा रहे थे। रास्ते में वो काशी वाराणसी में पहुंचे। वहां पर रूप गोस्वामी पहले से राजा का मंत्रित्व छोड़कर अपने छोटे भाई अनुपम के साथ में महाप्रभु से मिलने के लिए वृंदावन की ओर चले। और सनातन गोस्वामी जेल में थे, सब कुछ रुपए पैसे घूस देकर जेलर से और जेल से निकल करके आए। और मुस्लिम वो क्या होते हैं,
दरवेश,
दरवेश की भांति केस बढ़ा करके मैले कुचैले कपड़े पहनकर वहां पर उपस्थित हुए। और महाप्रभु जी घर के अंदर बैठे थे, उन्होंने देखो तो कोई साधु आया है। लोग बाहर के देख रहे, नहीं कोई साधु तो नहीं, अरे देखो कोई है तो ले आओ,
दरवेश है।
उन्होंने कहा जे तो मुस्लिम एक दरवेश है, साधु बुला लाओ,
उसको बुलाओ।
और जोहित महाप्रभु देखे दौड़े उनको पकड़ करके आलिंगन करने के लिए। सनातन, मैं अब मुसलमान हो गया हूं, आप मुझे मत छुइए, मैं बहुत अपवित्र हूं। और महाप्रभु जी ने कहा तुमको पवित्र बनाने के लिए मैं खुद अपने को पवित्र बनाने के लिए तुम्हारा स्पर्श करना चाहिए। फिर सनातन गोस्वामी का मुसलमान का वेश दाढ़ी ये सब खत्म करा के मुंडन करा करके और पुराने वस्त्र किसी का लेकर के महाप्रभु जी के निकट आए और प्रश्न किया। रामचंद्र, हिंदी में अंग्रेजी में बोल दीजिए, बोलिए बोलिए जल्दी संक्षेप में बोल दीजिए।
हिंदी में बोला, हिंदी में क्या बोलेंगे,
देरी मत लगाइए।
महाप्रभु वाज इन काशी एंड सनातन गोस्वामी
फर्स्ट व्हाट गुरुदेव सर व्हाट गुरुदेव स्पोक दैट यू हैव टू स्पीक
व्हेन गुरुदेव वेंट फॉर पूरी। अरे जल्दी से करो, देरी क्या लगा रहे हैं।
वही बता रहा हूं, महाप्रभु बैठ गए काशी
इन मैट रूपा सनातन अनुपा
व्हेन चैतन्य महाप्रभु वाज इन काशी ही मेट Rupa Goswami, who was going to meet his brother in Vrindavan, Anupam. And also, Sanatan Goswami, brother of Rupa Goswami, he escaped from the jail of a Muslim,
Hussain Shah.
Hussain Shah, and he met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When he came to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was inside his house. And he said, oh, one saintly person has come, please bring him. And when devotee went, he said, there is no any saintly person. There is a Muslim with a long beard. Then Mahaprabhu said, bring him inside, he is not Muslim. And Mahaprabhu embraced Sanatan Goswami. Sanatan Goswami said, don't touch me. I am coming from the Muslim king. I am a Mohammedan now. And Mahaprabhu said, you are not Mohammedan. I am embracing you to purify myself. And then he shaved and also he took dhoti, old dhoti of one of the devotees, and he wore those dress And then Sanatan Goswami, he asked Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he said,
Then Sanatan Goswami asked him, Ke ami kare mar ja raha par tapatra hai yahan jaan nahi jaani kam nahi tha. Oh Prabhu, I don't know who am I. And why I am enjoying endless pain of endless birth and death, always moving in cyclic order of birth and death. And how can I may be saved by all these things? Then Mahaprabhu became very happy. We should know why Sanatana Goswami asked this question, that who am I? Did he not knew that I am Sanatana? I am from South India, Brahmin. No, he knew, but he knew that we are not this
physical body.
What this body is? Only a bag of blood, urine, latrine, and so many things. If you will do like this, what you will see in this body? Only blood, urine, and latrine, and so many things. So we are not this, but in this, there is soul and super soul. Krishna has given very mercifully this human form. Only in this form, we can know by the mercy of Gurudev that who am I? Who is Krishna, super soul? All the jivas have a beautiful form, quality to serve Radha Krishna. But now it is in
what way?
Dormant way. We have forget Krishna, and that is why we have forget, who am I? We have some relation with Krishna, Radhika. We have a form, beautiful form. We have so many qualities, but now covered with this
physical body
and
subtle body.
Mind. So Sanatana Goswami first told, who am I? Then Mahaprabhu told, you are eternal
servant
of Krishna. Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. And you are eternal servant of Krishna. But Krishna is very bibhu, that is,
bibhu means no end,
unlimited,
infinite, unlimited.
Infinite. And jivas are
finite.
Minute.
So they can be covered with maya. Krishna cannot be covered by his maya. He can control maya, but jivas cannot. So they have forgotten Krishna and themselves also. Like he told that there was a wealthy person He has son, only one son. He went to for business to any another city, and there he left his body. That person had kept so much money underground in his house, but the boy never knew. One astrologer came
in front of his father
and asked, "Why you are so unhappy? Your father has
so much wealth.
Anywhere in this house, he has kept
so much wealth,
hidden too much money for you." But he could not tell at the time of his death. Oh, only you should dig some earth in east side. Then you can easily have that money. But if you will dig in south of your house, then so many
snakes.
Python snakes will come and bite you. Don't dig in west. Don't dig in
north.
There are so many
obstacles up there.
So many
danger.
Poisonous insect and worms are there. Only in east. And then he there dig something and found so much gold and coins in a big pot. What is this? We have our father Krishna has kept bhakti ratna,
jewels
of bhakti. But he could not forget it. And then astrologer came, that is Krishna came, or he sent his guru, his any high class of Vaishnava, and he told, "Oh, without bhakti you cannot have. By this you can have. Oh, golden coins means, oh, prema bhakti, by which you can serve Radha and Krishna conjugal, and then you can be happy." Then what is the sadhana of bhakti? Sadhan bhakti? Then he told, Sravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasam, Sakham, Atmanivedanam. By these bhaktis, anyone can have bhav bhakti. Bhav bhakti is very high, very high. And after that, you will have prem, praja prem. Even gopi prem is highest prem. By this you can be happy forever. This is sadhan, and the effect of the sadhan is prema bhakti, braja bhakti, in this way too. And then he went to towards Vrindavan. In the way, again he met Rup Goswami at Allahabad, Prayag. And then, there he was 10 days, speaking Harikatha to Rup. And he inspired all bhakti rush in heart. And that is why he was able to write Ujjwal Nin Mani, Bhakti Rasami Sindhu.
Lalit Madhav, Vidagdha Madhav.
So many books. Valli. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I'm telling, ocean of rush, one drop. Bhakti rush is like very big
ocean,
endless ocean. I'm telling only one drop of that. And by joy, you can make whole world sink in that ocean of rush, in one also drop. And then he told, and that Srila Rupa Goswami has written in Ujjwal Nin Mani, Bhakti Rasami Sindhu and all books. In Dwas, he trained Rup Goswami. And then he went to Vrindavan, and Rup Goswami again went to Jagannath Puri to meet with Krishna. So these are the swift pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Gaur Premarande.
गोविंद दामोदर महाना की
हरे कृष्णा
जाते ना तीन तीन नाम उधर गोविंद दामोदर सब बोली करे मैं देख
तुम्हारा प्रोग्राम
ओए तो गोविंद दामोदर माधव जी
तुम्हारा हरि नाम एंड इनिशिएशन विल टेक प्लेस एट मिस्टर हेमंत हाउस यू नो वन थिंग इज देयर आई हैव हर्ड दैट टुमारो इज प्रोबेबली सन रन समथिंग लाइक दिस Too much crowd and probably cars are not allowed to come to downtown area. So we request you, whoever wants to come, they should come through sky train. And this sky train, for this you have to stop at two stations. Waterfront station, that is the closest. From waterfront station, you can come to Hemant Prabhu's house. His house is at 120 West Hastings Street.
1205.
1205.